to discuss about an extremely important topic, which is employment and chronic conditions, chronic health conditions. Can you please tell us why it is a very important topic nowadays?
Since the aging of population is increasing and since the incredible number of people that are suffering from chronic disease, also the employment sector is becoming more and more a sector that needs actions and interventions so that people who are suffering from chronic conditions feel that they are included and that they have means in the work sector to stay at work and to return to work. Also, it is also important to consider the employment sector as one of the key sectors where you can act with prevention and with actions that can increase the well-being of all workers, so that also you can do actions that help the population to stay healthier, to have an increasing well-being. And the employment sector then becomes one of the key sectors where health can be played, so that health is in all sectors.
So it seems like a very tough challenge. What is the answer that the Joint Action CRODIS Plus gave to this challenge?
Well, it took 3 years to people from many countries and institutions from many different backgrounds and settings to provide an answer that we are releasing with a tool that we call Workbox. What is the Workbox? The CRODIS Plus Workbox. It is an instrument that we are providing as a result of the joint action to all people in Europe and to all member states in Europe and to all different stakeholders, so as to increase the well-being at work and to help people who have chronic diseases to stay at work and to remain at work. The Workbox is composed of two elements: the training tool for managers and the toolkit for the workplace. In the first part of the training tool for managers, we are trying to introduce some key elements that help managers to do two actions. First of all, evaluate if all the workers are feeling a sense of inclusion in the workplace. Why this is important? If you have an inclusive workplace, then all the workers, including also those who have chronic condition, can feel that they are participating fully at the working life. And what are the working conditions? We are addressing our training tool to all managers in all type of small, medium and large enterprise in the public and the private sector. And what are the chronic diseases we are mentioning in the training tool? Chronic diseases are, according to the World Health Organization, diseases that don't pass from person to person and stay for a long time. In this sense, we have many chronic conditions that are affecting one worker out of four. Diabetes, obesity, neurological disorders such as headaches, depression, low back pain, and cancer. All these diseases are affecting a large part of the population. One worker out of four already today is suffering from one chronic disease. And the training tool is made for managers to understand what are chronic conditions, how can you help people with chronic conditions, and which are the different tips that you can use to improve the health of people with chronic conditions.
Could you please tell us more about this checklist on environmental inclusiveness?
Yes, so the training tool has one checklist that has been developed to help managers to understand whether all the different sectors of the organization, of the enterprise, are able to provide inclusiveness to every person. It is divided with four sections. Each of it has 10 points, and people have to answer yes or no. And it concerns the different areas of an enterprise, of an organization, and it can be used in a dual mode. First of all, it could be a self-assessment of managers. How much do you know about the inclusiveness of your enterprise? And then you have a score, and then you identify which are the weak areas that you can improve with some actions. The second use is that managers can do it, but also people that work in the enterprise, in the organization, can do it. And they can then compare in an anonymous manner what are the weaknesses and the strengths that the different counterparts identify inside an enterprise. And this allows also to do the first step for an inclusive environment, that is eliminating barriers and increasing facilitators so that everybody feels that they are participating in the workplace.
Another section of the training tool for managers is on workability. Can you please explain us more about this this theme, this topic?
Yes. Once we speak about workability, it is a concept that is quite known since many years in the work sector. However, why we wanted to introduce this concept in the training? It is very important that managers understand in a broad approach to people who are working in an enterprise that it's not only important to know what are the limitations of the person, but also how much the environment can play the role as barrier or facilitator. So workability is the ability to work of a person in that specific health condition, in that specific environment. So it's not judging the health condition of the person. It is judging whether the environment, the working environment, is able to perform as a facilitator to that person in that specific moment with the health condition. Measuring workability then, it can be done using the workability index that is referred into our training tool. And using that tool, people are able to understand whether some reasonable accommodation, some changes in the environment should be done.
Another section of the training tool, there are 7 tips for managers. Can you please explain these tips?
Yes, this training has been developed so as to be a very practical training tool for managers. And what we felt when we were testing this training with the different enterprises, because this training has been tested in 7 countries and in several enterprises with different types of background. What was felt that was necessary is that managers want fast and quick tips so as to make changes, and managers could be from the human resources, but not only, that could also create an environment that is helpful. One of the things that is mostly needed by people is usually, if they suffer of a chronic condition, the ability to not feel stigmatized. Second is to have time to go to the medical or to the health care services. And the third is to find the adjustment in the work time so that health is considered, but also not discriminated the person through because of health. And when we mentioned the tips, one of the main things that came out from several interviews and several surveys that we did is that certainly the ability to have flexi time or smart work, it was mostly felt very useful for people with chronic condition, so that they can play around the time and they can perform better if they are able also to balance the health needs as well as the working needs. And together in the tips that we give to managers, we are providing several manners in which training can be done not only to the person who suffers of health condition, but to all workers, so as to have a peer-to-peer good relationship, and the burden of disease is shared between the whole enterprise. All people in one moment of their life can suffer of a health condition. And if you have a good environment in which this can be understood, and if you are able to create the good atmosphere in the workplace, this helps everybody to feel that there is no discrimination, there is no stigma for that. And this is quite a complex task for managers, but it is essential for the good going of the work. There are many benefits for everybody in approaching the area of chronic condition. If you are able to have a good inclusion of people with chronic condition, then you are able to create a good atmosphere for all workers in your enterprise.
What is a reasonable accommodation, and do you talk about reasonable accommodation in the training tool for managers?
We have been really dedicating a section to reasonable accommodation, because reasonable accommodation are accommodation that an enterprise or an organization has to do to make the job adaptable to the person in a manner that is feasible, but in a manner that tries to alleviate and eliminate the barriers. So we've been describing several examples of reasonable accommodation, and we wish that every manager has in mind what could be a reasonable accommodation for each specific case or each specific worker that might have a chronic disease and need a reasonable accommodation.